Invasive shothole borers are inflicting severe damage on Southern California's urban forest, and the beetles continue to spread to the north and east. To manage this pest, it is critical to find infestations early through a regular monitoring program that combines both visual tree inspections with trapping. Trapping is not a control method for shothole borers, but it is a powerful monitoring tool in a management program. Traps can be extremely helpful in identifying sources of infestation, monitoring the spread of beetles, and identifying newly infested areas. Trapping is especially useful for large and inaccessible areas where regular visual tree inspections are not practical. Two types of traps are commonly used with invasive shothole borers: Lindgren funnel traps and sticky panel traps. Each type of trap has its pros and cons. With Lindgren funnel traps, insects land on the trap and fall down through the funnels until they end up in a cup of preservative at the bottom. These traps are durable and reusable, lasting for multiple field seasons. They are relatively easy to service and maintain, and then provide clean beetle samples that are easier to identify. However, they're more expensive than sticky panel traps, require more frequent service and cleaning, and are sometimes subject to vandalism or intrusion by curious passersby. The second type of trap is a sticky panel trap. And as the name implies, insects that fly into the trap become stuck in the surface of the panel.
Sticky traps are less expensive and require less frequent service, but they are only good for one field season. And captured insects may be harder to remove and identify due to the insects being stuck to the panel. Due to their much lower cost, sticky panel traps, specifically bark beetle traps, are generally the type of trap used by California agencies involved in surveying and monitoring for invasive shothole borers. For this type of pest, funnel traps and sticky traps use a plant-based chemical lure called quercivorol. Only one lure should be used per trap, as a high concentration of lures can actually make them less effective. Check the label to see how long the lure should last, either 30 days or 60 days. Lures should be stored in the freezer until ready to be deployed. Otherwise, the chemical may be released prior to trap installation. Inside the lure package, you will find a sealed pouch that contains a nickel-sized transparent membrane that is semi-permeable to allow the slow release of the chemical scent. This is the lure. Do not open the pouch. Another note is that traps shouldn't be placed too close together. A separation of at least 20 yards is recommended. However, you don't need to worry about traps attracting beetles from far away. Traps will only attract nearby beetles and will only confirm the presence of them. One of the most important decisions to make is where to place the traps. Traps should be placed where they can be easily accessible for maintenance, but away from high traffic areas. Avoid areas subject to high winds or where they may repeatedly get wet, such as irrigated lawns or planters. To avoid attracting beetles to the target trees, traps should not be hung from the tree branches or placed under the canopy. The first step in installing the trap is the construction of a hanger or stand, which can be made from aluminum conduit, PVC, or any sturdy material. For a funnel trap, the hanger should be about 5 feet long with a 2-foot bend at the top. A 2-foot piece of rebar is hammered into the ground and the hanger is slipped over it. The trap is suspended from the hanger and a lure is suspended in the center of the trap using plastic extensions. The collection cup at the bottom should be around 1/3 full of soapy water or 70% propylene glycol-based antifreeze. Antifreeze is generally preferred because it preserves the beetles better, evaporates very slowly, and requires less frequent inspections. Ethylene glycol should not be used as it is more toxic and can attract look-alike beetles while deterring invasive shothole borers. If soapy water is used in the collection cup, a funnel trap will need to be inspected every week. If a propylene glycol solution is used, inspections can be extended to once per month. For a sticky trap, a simple stand can be constructed using a 2-foot rebar stake and a 5-foot piece of PVC pipe or aluminum conduit. Unlike the funnel trap stand, there is no bend at the top. The rebar is hammered into the ground and the PVC pipe is slipped over the top. The traps have a hole at the top and bottom, so not only should the traps be attached with binder clips, but a hole should be drilled into the PVC pipe and the trap connected with wire or zip ties. The lure should be attached near the top of the trap with a zip tie or twist tie. The sticky trap will come folded together with the sticky side inside. You will need to peel the trap apart and fold it backwards so the sticky side is outside. Be careful and take your time with this as the adhesive is extremely sticky. It is always a good idea to have signage on each trap. Signage can be either fixed to the sticky surface or fixed to the trap stand with a zip tie. Trap signage should include the trap number and contact information. Outreach messaging and a QR code are helpful but not required. To retrieve insects from a funnel trap, filter the contents of the collection cup with a fine mesh strainer. The filtered antifreeze can be reused in the trap over and over. Disposable paint strainers work well if the step is done in the field. After straining, you can place your sample, paint strainer and all, in a labeled plastic bag and bring it to your lab or office facility. You can also bring the entire contents of the collection cup to be processed. For sticky traps, insects can be removed with tweezers and placed in a sampling vial with ethanol. Or if the trap has collected a large quantity of beetles, simply remove and replace the panel. Panel replacement is also advised if there is a significant amount of debris or dirt stuck to the trap. The beetles collected with either kind of trap should be stored in vials containing ethanol and labeled with date and trap number.